Hey everybody, Todd Isbrunner here, author of What Every Man Needs to Know, How to Master Faith, Family, Fitness, and Finances. But I don't want to talk about that today. I want to talk about something really that has been on my heart for, really for a long time, but especially now. So my wife Wendy and I have opportunity many times to have devotions in the morning together. In fact, Wendy is recording right now. Hi, Wendy.
Hi everybody.
And we're in a really, really unusual time of history, okay? This is being recorded towards the end of April 2020. And we are in a place and time in history that none of us have ever experienced before. The coronavirus has caused a complete and total shutdown of the economy, a shutdown of life for many people. We've literally been not just encouraged, but almost mandated to be in a lockdown situation, which means many people are isolated at home. They can't go off to work, can't run off to stores, can't be gathering at restaurants and parties and all this. It's all been sort of just stopped. It's like we've been paralyzed. And, you know, fortunately for Wendy and I mean, we actually work from home, so that's not been a big deal. But so many people are going through so many hardships and challenges and fearful, scary, anxious things in their lives. And as Wendy and I were talking this morning, again, we were reminded this is a time where you really could take advantage of it, since you have to be sort of pulled back from the regular routine of life. Why not pick some things of real value that you typically don't spend time on? Now, I know a lot of people, Wendy, you even got caught in this a little bit, like, all right, let's get some spring cleaning done. Like, there's
totally.
Some closets.
Let's clean this stuff out.
Let's get rid of this stuff in these drawers, whatever. All good, right? Practical things we can do. But beyond that, there are some other things of real value that we can do to really benefit who we are and what we do in life. I'm thinking about
cleaning out our hearts.
Yeah, right.
Yes.
Do like a heart transplant? Is that what you're talking
about?
Well,
kinda.
Where we can fill our hearts up with good things and our minds. I've got a grandson who decided, well, since I can't go out to work, I'm going to spend my time studying a new language. See, that's great. That's awesome. I know other people are taking online courses, learning new things in life. But there's something that rises above all the things that we could be spending time on. I believe the number one thing, not just during this time of lockdown, but during all times of life, this would be the number one thing you could devote your time to, you could put your heart into. And I'm talking about getting to know God better. And I almost have to laugh, Wendy, when I say that. He's like, oh, so he's going to teach us how to know God better. Wow, isn't he special?
I mean, who are you?
But the reality is, deep inside of every person, there is...
But wait, hold on. I have to interrupt.
Yeah.
Because you did go to seminary.
I went to seminary, yes, years and years ago.
So, I don't know. I think you're qualified.
Well, okay. So, qualifications or not, everybody has something inside of them that there's just this, like, this is itch. There's this space inside of our heart that needs to be filled up. And God made
yes.
it that way. He put a little hole in our hearts, a little vacuum that's got room only for Him. And if we will open up that place within ourselves to let God in and fill us up with who He is, everything else starts to make sense. We literally can become successful in life. When I say successful, I don't mean having a fat bank account and a nice home. I mean understand the purpose for why God put you here, and then letting Him work through you the fulfillment of His plans and His purpose for your life so that you can be successful. But you gotta get to know God. And the best way, I was gonna say the only way, but that's really not true. There are numerous ways that God speaks to us. But the best way to really get to know who He is, what He's like, what He wants, is right here in the B-I-B-L-E, the Bible. And of course, I realize a lot of people don't, you know, pick up books and Bibles anymore. They use their apps. Not a problem.
Okay, but Todd, a lot of people don't even know where to really start.
Yeah, very true. It's like
it's a big
this,
book.
This book
and
is
it doesn't always make sense.
Filled with things that I don't understand. I don't get when it was written, why it was written, who put it together, all of that stuff. I understand that there are lots and lots of challenges if you don't know anything about the Bible. But let me just throw all that off to the side for just a moment and just say this. This is the living Word of God. That means that every word that was written here, God says, was breathed from his spirit into men who then scribed it out for him. They literally wrote on his behalf. So it is a trustworthy, living word, which means you can come to this Bible and ask God very simply, God, would you show me who you are? Show me what you want from me. Show me how to conduct my life. And anywhere and everywhere in his word, there will be life-giving principles and insights into who God is and what he wants with you. And so I just want to encourage you, don't get caught up in feeling like, it's just too complicated. I don't know enough about it. I don't have a seminary degree like that, dude. You don't need that. You just need the ability to either read or to hear, because you can listen to it on apps as well. And I promise you, when you do that, you will start to understand more and more about who he is and what your relationship is like with him. And the rest of life will start to make sense. Wendy, you and I were talking about the best antidote to fear, because so many people are fearful right now.
Right.
The best antidote is faith. And it's not the kind of faith that I'm going to believe God to do this and this and this and that for me. It's the kind of faith that says, I believe you are God Almighty, who made all things, including me. And I believe that you have the best for me.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe that in spite of all the things in this life that I cannot figure out, including this crazy coronavirus, that
coronas?
Doesn't make sense.
Coronavirus.
the coronavirus. Wow. I don't even understand enough to say what the actual term is. Right? What is it? COVID-19?
Yes.
The specific version of this coronavirus? All that stuff may not make any sense to us and create fear. But the thing that does make sense is God, in his sovereignty, in his power, in his oversight of all things throughout the entire cosmos, knows exactly what's going on and knows what he can do with this inside the hearts of people. So
when we talk about faith, Ty, like we were talking this morning,
yeah,
it's like the apostles. Actually, the man, whenever at the whatever, see, I don't even know where the transfiguration happened, right?
Okay, so Jesus was on the Mount of Transfiguration,
yeah, okay. See,
and a little bit of heaven showed up, and he had a couple of the guys with him.
Right,
and so
one of the guys was sharing that he needed help with his unbelief. He believes,
yeah,
but help me with my unbelief.
Yeah, so Jesus comes down the mountain, and they've just had glory time on heaven, and he comes down into the pit where his disciples are frustrated because a man with his son, the son has got a demon, and the disciples could not drive the demon out, could not help the boy, couldn't heal him and deliver him. And the man said to Jesus, is there anything that you can do? If you can, and Jesus says, if. So anything's possible for him who believes, and you have to have faith. And the man said to Jesus, I believe, you got to help my unbelief. That's kind of
where
all of us are at, right? We all want stronger faith. And the reality is the way to have stronger faith is to have faith and to use the faith that you have. The way to grow your faith literally is to get to know God better. So I don't want to turn this into a big sermon. I just want to encourage you and offer you some hope and a challenge, if you will, that if you will come to his word and you'll make it the number one priority, with the expectation that God will use what's in his word to help you understand who he is, what your relationship is like, you will become more successful in every area of life. And the fear will reduce, and the faith will grow, and the strength inside of you will become very apparent as you put this first in your life.
Yes.
So it doesn't mean you have to sit down for hours and hours and try to figure it all out. Take 15 minutes a day. And if you don't know where to start, I'm going to give you two suggestions. One, just start with the Gospel of John. The Apostle John was so intimate with Jesus and really knew how to write about the things that you need to know about Jesus. It's a great place, the Gospel of John. Another habit that Billy Graham had was he would read 5 Psalms a day and 1 proverb. So just start there. Keep it simple, but start somewhere with the expectation that, God, I know you want to speak to me. I'm open. I will listen. Show me more about who you are.
Oh, man. You just said it. Expectation. It's about expecting God to show up, expecting him to reveal what he needs to reveal for us individually, right? In order to hear him, how we will hear him.
That's it, exactly. Got to have the expectation. Look, open up your Bible. Go do it today. Pick a good time. Pick a spot in your house. This is kind of one of my favorite spots. And just
I'm
in that chair over there. But that's okay. Thanks for sharing. Pick a spot. Get going at it. And we're in this thing together. Let's encourage each other. Let's read his word and get to know him better.